Squad, we got Sha-Rock with the Funky 4 plus 1 up in the crib tonight. The original female of rap, the first female to sign to a major, Sugar Hill Records. This house where I said all work and no play. What's up? Big L the Don just stepped up in the face and said, the Don is here, aka the American Dream. Powdery nose. You tripping, Big L the Don. You don't even mess with that, man. Oh, we got DeWitt Justice giving me a shout out. Said, Sha-Rock, the number one. Better believe it, baby. And she up in the crib tonight. We appreciate her coming by and showing us some love. Put on there the plus one. That's right. You know your history then, huh? Yeah. What's up, Big L Don? How you feeling tonight, baby? Guys on that powder, I don't know what you're tripping, man. You know you just playing anyways. Oh, dog. Oh, shit. Here go Big L Don. He always known for talking little shit. Talking about, oh, man, Sha-Rock. Where's the lotion? Come on, man. Come on, dog.
Hey.
Let's keep it clean now. He said, groovy, okay.
Hold me back,
cause
this is my song.
Uh-oh, Sha-Rock song right here.
Shout out to Usher.
Big shout out to Usher. Did the CD come out today? Yes, Usher CD out tonight. Today also E-40 CD out today. Go check them out. And also Wu Massacre out today. Wu-Tang. Texas housewife, she talking a little bit of junk. She talking about Usher. Now where the lotion at? Alright, crazy. Miguel and Don says the Usher is hot. That's what's up, man. I have to check it out.
Shawty, you already know what it is.
Texas housewife said she'll call Usher daddy. I know Big L Don, I just said it a second ago, you must have missed it. E-40 came out today. Yeah, E-Feezy, E-40 finds a belly. That's my man right there from the Bay. Justice said, where's this show streaming from? Texas, Central Texas, K-Town, Killeen. From Killeen, but everybody in here ain't from Killeen. Lady 31 just came up in the crib. What up, Miss Lady? How you feeling tonight?
you say daddy's home. Oh, home for me. I know you've been waiting.
Yeah, with Justin said you like the setup. Keep it funky, my dude. That's what's up, man. Appreciate the love. Taylor Dawn said, "Cool Rod having the chokehold." Daddy's home. Got a special guest tonight for ladies first. We got Sha-Rock of the Funky 4 Plus 1 up in the crib tonight.
Funky.
Yeah, the first female MC ever signed to a major. We got history up in the crib tonight. What's up? Go ahead, tell the viewers a little bit about yourself.
Yes, I'm here. And for those who don't know me, I am Sha-Rock from the Funky 4 Plus 1. And of course, DJ Snow has said that I was the first female to sign to a major, but that's not everything. I am the first female hip-hop MC of all times. Forget what you have heard, and I know y'all probably thought it was probably somebody else, but I'm cut from a different cloth. I come from the 70s when hip-hop first started in the South Bronx. For me, I started off in 1976. I was a B-girl. So for all y'all that's out there in California, I know we got some breakdancers out there. That's what I started out first. I have a book coming out that's called Luminary Icon. And it really tells the story of Sha-Rock and the Funky Four and how we have paved the way for every artist that you could even imagine. Back in the days, it was us and Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, along with African Bambaataa. We all grew up together. And a lot of times, most females, there have not been no females that has come out and spoke about the history and the culture of the 70s. A lot of people that don't know the history of hip-hop think that it started in the 80s. But for us, hip-hop was on the street at least 5 or 6, 7 years prior to it going on whack, okay? And so that's where I come from. I come from the era of hip-hop, B-girls, breakdancing, graffiti, that's the era that I come. So I want everybody, I came here actually for my homeboy Snow and Rob, but I want everybody to really, you know, get my book that's called Luminary Icon. It'll be out May 28th in every major bookstore that you could even imagine. It will also, right now, it's on Amazon.com, okay? So if you go to Amazon.com, you can do a pre-order if you want to. It's called Luminary Icon. You can type up Luminary Icon and you can type up Sha-Rock. So it gives you a history, and it's a tell-all book of the beginnings of the culture for me as a female, as being the first female in hip-hop culture.
The first, that's right.
Numero uno.
Yeah.
Make
sure everybody go get that book. You know,
I'm
going
to cop that book. It's going right over there. Definitely.
So it would settle everything that you have been told, you know, from the media to the movie.
That's right. It ain't no MC Light or Queen Latifah.
Those are my homegirls, though.
Yeah.
Those
big shout out to them.
Those are my homegirls. But
this is the number one, right?
They know
this
the first.
It ain't Roxanne even.
You know what? Those are
not
my homegirls.
Not the Sean Tate. I'm talking about the one with the blonde hair.
Those are my homegirls, but I am the first. And I'm here to tell
the first right here in the crib.
Oh, yes.
We're making history up in the crib.
Okay. Most definitely, man.
Yeah, so let me get a couple questions in. So exactly when did it actually start? Like, when did the legacy actually start?
Well, for the hip-hop culture, you would say 1973.
Well, for
legacy. It's 76. I started 76. As a B-girl. And okay. So basically every MC from Melly Mel to, African Boy, everybody that was out back then, if you was an MC, you had to start as a breakdancer or a B-girl or B-boy. Back then, we didn't call it breakdancing.
Yeah.
We called it B-girl, B-boy. You had to start off that way. And then you graduated to an MC. And for me, 1976.
Shit, I wasn't even born yet.
You
I was
right.
78.
1976.
That's what's up, man. Most